U.S. is getting closer to business as usual. All 50 states have now begun phasing in plans to reopen. And though the numbers of new cases are dropping in some states, many have not met the federal criteria of a 14-day downward trajectory of cases. As of Tuesday, at least 17 states showed an upward trend in average daily cases, a rise of at least 10% over the previous 7 days. Only 16 states had a drop in new cases of 10% or more. Jackson Prosco reports.
As the U.S. economy sputters back to life, the road ahead has never looked more uncertain. Just 2 days after work resumed at a Ford plant outside Chicago, thousands of workers were sent home and production was halted after one employee tested positive for COVID-19.
Social distancing really doesn't work.
I'm upset that they're bringing us back so soon.
All 50 states are pressing ahead with full or partial reopening. There's nervousness about what will happen next as people return to stores and malls.
I feel like as long as we follow the guidelines that are out, then we'll be okay.
President Trump continues to project confidence as he champions the economy, tweeting that the G7 summit, called off due to the pandemic, should take place as originally scheduled in early June at Camp David. A great sign to all, normalization.
So, yes, we need to keep meeting as leaders. Whether that's virtual, in person, we'll certainly take a look at what the U.S. is proposing.
Safety measures remain a contentious issue in the U.S. In Michigan, barbers and stylists cut hair on the steps of the state capitol, defying orders to stay closed.
Our rights don't come from the government, they come from God. Simple as that.
While the Centers for Disease Control is facing criticism over 60 pages of reopening guidelines, they were amended to remove any mention of churches or religious institutions.
You can't be overly prescriptive. Not every state and every county and every jurisdiction has the same infection rate.
The guidelines give a glimpse of what the new normal may look like across America, with regular temperature checks recommended for teachers and students in schools, and restaurants told to use disposable dishes to prevent customers from spreading the virus as they slowly reopen their doors. Jackson Prosco, Global News, Washington.
Because of the pandemic, UNESCO, the UN cultural body, says 1 in 8 of the world's museums could close permanently. Redmond Shannon takes a look at how some are coping, hoping they have a future.
UNESCO says 85,000 museums worldwide have been forced to close during the COVID-19 pandemic. For those that have reopened, the Do Not Touch signs have taken on a whole new meaning. Although physical distancing doesn't seem to be a big issue just yet.
Walking up the big staircase, there's nobody, so it's a strange, almost eerie experience.
And a far from relaxing experience for visitors or staff. Our financial losses are catastrophic, says a spokeswoman for Belgium's Museum of Fine Arts. Many museums struggle to make ends meet at the best of times, and after 2 months without revenue, they now need to heavily limit visitor numbers. This exhibition, marking 500 years since the death of Raphael, reopens in June.
We will be organizing small groups of around 6 people. That will be welcomed by a guard, which will be a sort of a chaperone.
Canadians who've come to London will know the National Gallery, opposite Canada House in Trafalgar Square.
Like many London museums and galleries, it doesn't charge for entry, but it still relies heavily on suggested donations, its cafes and gift shops.
We quickly realised that we were, in effect, no longer a physical gallery. We'd become an online gallery.
The detailed website has been a way to welcome virtual visitors, but it's never quite the same.
One of the things about going to a museum is, you stand in front of a picture. It has a sort of physical relationship of scale with your body.
Getting those bodies in front of exhibits as soon as possible will be key to keeping museums afloat. Redmond Shannon, Global News, London.
The new series that goes inside the COVID-19 pandemic, from the front lines to the everyday heroes helping us cope with the unprecedented change. Coronavirus, the new reality. A Global News special, Sundays at 7 on Global.